are necessary under the unit clipping and display file compilation. First of all, we must know what is meant by clipping, and then we will have the process regarding the clipping process. Clipping is nothing but a process of identifying the visible part of picture and invisible part against the specified region. Now, what is that specified region? That you must know. That is clipping window. The region against which a picture is to be clipped is called as clipping window. Now, this particular clipping window is generally a rectangular shape. Say this boundary of clipping window can be specified as x left, x right, y bottom and y top. Particular picture is to be displayed on this particular clipping window, which is generally of rectangular shape. Here we must come to analyze that particular pixel or particular line or particular picture is to be clipped. Now, how that clipping process is applied? First of all, we will discuss about the point clipping. What is meant by point? That is the pixel which is present on the screen. Now, particular point is to be clipped if it follows two criteria. That is, whenever x is greater than or equals to x left and less than or equals to x right, and the same for the same point we can have particular point is to be displayed on a 2D plane with its x and y coordinates. Now, for its x coordinates, this particular criteria must be satisfied. That is, this x point must be lies between x left and x right. Similarly, for the y coordinate, that is, y should be greater than or equals to y bottom and less than or equals to y top. Means what? If particular pixel is satisfies these two conditions, then that line is, that particular point is said to be present in the clipping window. If it doesn't satisfy these two criteria, then we can conclude that that particular point is not visible or not present in this specified region. Now, this is related to the point clipping. Now, as far as the line clipping is concerned, we must know what is the line and what are the certain criteria of line clipping. Say, this is a clipping window. And for example, we are taking certain lines present on this clipping window. Say, line P1, P2. Similarly, the line P3, P4. On the same platform, line P5, P6. Similarly, the line P7. As we know that clipping is a process of identifying the portion of the picture which is visible and which is not. If particular portion is visible, then we have to display that portion. And if particular portion is invisible, we have to discard it. The same process we need to apply on the lines which are present in this figure. Say, line P1, P2. This line is completely visible. So here we need to apply the visibility test. That is, On the edge at every line present in this particular figure, we have to apply three visibility tests. That is, whether particular line is completely visible, or it is completely invisible, or it is partially visible. Now, depending on the location of endpoint of line, we can say that particular line is belongs to one of these categories. That is, say the line P1, P2. Here, for this line, both endpoints are present interior to the clipping window. Then, this particular line is belongs to which category? Completely visible category. See here, another line, P3, P4. Both the endpoints are out of this particular clipping window. Then, this particular line is said to be completely invisible. Means here, for the completely invisible line, we have to follow the criteria that if the both endpoints of line are completely left of this clipping window, or completely right of this clipping window, or completely below this clipping window, or completely above the clipping window, then that line is said to be completely invisible. And if particular line doesn't belong to these two categories, then that line is said to be partially visible. Now for this partially visible, we have to follow two criteria. That first criteria is, if both the endpoints of line are in outside of the clipping window and some part of the line goes through this corner of the clipping window. This is the first criteria. That is, both the endpoints are exterior to the clipping window and some part of the line goes to this corner. And another criteria is, one of the endpoints of line is interior to the clipping window and another point is exterior to the clipping window, then this line belongs to third category. That is, partially visible. Now, for applying these visibility tests, we must know the location of endpoints of line. Now, for this line clipping, there are two main algorithms. And that two main algorithms we are going to discuss now. There are two main algorithms. That is, first one is Sutherland-Cohen line clipping algorithm, and another one is a midpoint subdivision algorithm. Now here we are going to discuss about this first one initially, and then we will have a discussion about second one. Tells us that the visible part of portion portion is displayed on this shaded portion. Now, as per this algorithm, the Sutherland Cohen assigns the 4-digit region code to these 9 different subregions, and that subregions tells us the position of 8 point of line. Now, how to assign these region codes? Initially, these region codes assigned as 0000, that is group of 4 zeros to each and every subregion. And we need to apply 4-step process for setting the bit position which is present on this particular group of 4. Now, initially we are assigning all zeros as a region codes to 9 different subregions.
Its fourth bit as 1.
three tests on particular endpoints. This algorithm tells us the line-fitting process, that is, whether particular part of line is visible or not. If particular part is visible, then we have to display that part on the clipping window. And if particular part is out of screen, then we have to just ignore it. Once we have got particular region codes of 9 different subregions, then we have to follow this algorithm. As the first step of this algorithm is read the endpoints of line. Say line AB. For example, this line AB is present in this subregion. For example, A, B. Read the endpoints of line. Second step is read the corners of the line, the corners of the clipping window. Why to read the corners of clipping window? Because we have to specify the boundary of clipping window so that we can have a division of particular clipping window into 9 different subregions. Third step is assign the region codes that we have done. Assign the region codes depending on these four scenarios. Fourth step in this algorithm is apply the visibility tests. That is, whether that line is completely visible or completely invisible or partially visible. Now, we have taken this example as the line A, B. Here, A and B, these two endpoints are having different region codes. Now, apply the visibility test as if the line is completely visible, then for this completely visibility line, if both the region codes are 0, 0, 0, 0, then that line is said to be completely visible. Here, for the completely visibility of line, both the endpoints of the line must have the region codes as 0, 0, 0, 0. Then that line is said to be completely visible. Means that line is present in this particular area only. And this particular area is completely visible. Second, completely invisible. When the region codes of both the endpoints of line and the logical and operation of the same is results in non-zero result, at that time we can say that the line is completely invisible. For example, line AB. Here A, this particular endpoint has a region code as 1000. Here, A has a region code as 1001. And B has a region code as 1000. Then the logical and operation is nothing but similar to the multiplication of digits. Here, logical add operation 1 into 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, and 1, 1, 1. This one is a non-zero result. Non-zero result means one of these four digits is 1. Or in any of these four digits will be 1, at that time we can say that particular result is non-zero. Whereas exactly opposite, we can say that if the result of logical AND operation is 0, 0, 0, then that line is partially visible. Here, three conditions we have taken. When the line is said to be completely visible, if both the endpoints of line are having region codes as of 0, 0, 0, 0. Second case, when the logical AND operation of the region codes of line of both the endpoints is a non-zero, at that time we can say that line is completely invisible. And in the last case, if the logical AND operation of the region codes of both the endpoints of line results in all zeros, then that line is partially visible. For example, for this partially visible line, we'll take one example. If the line is present in this region, say PQ. Now, for this P and for this Q, different region codes are present. For this P, region code is 0, 0, 0, 1. And for this Q, the region code is 0, 0, 0, 0. The logical AND operation of this is 1, 0, 0, 0 into 0, 0, 0 into 0, 0, and same. So, this is a 0 result. As earlier we have discussed, if the result of logical AND operation of the region codes of both endpoints of line is 0, then that line is partially visible. Now, the fifth step of algorithm is, if the line is partially visible, then we have to follow one process, that is one case we have to consider here. This is a clipping window, and so this is the line. As per the previous stage, this line is partially visible. Now here we need to find out the intersection point of the line and the clipping window. Say here R is the intersection point and S is an intersection point. On these different segments, we have to again repeat the process as whether particular segment is completely visible or not. If it is completely invisible, we have to just ignore it. If particular segment is completely visible, we have to just display it. And if this particular segment is completely invisible, we have to just discard it or ignore it. So, these are the different process or different steps which are comes under this main algorithm, that is Sutherland Cohen line clipping algorithm. Now, another algorithm is there, that is midpoint subdivision algorithm. The name itself suggests its working principle. The first algorithm tells us this result, that is, if the line is completely visible, then display that line, say PQ. If the line is completely invisible, then we have to just discard this line. Means that we are not going to display this line, because this is out of this boundary of this clipping window. And the third case is, if the line is partially visible, then we have to just find out the intersection point of the line and boundary of clipping window. And then, whatever the segments we are getting, the same steps are repeated till we will get completely visible part and completely invisible part. If completely visible part is there, then we have to display it. And when we will get completely invisible part, then we have to just ignore it. Now, we are going to discuss about midpoint subdivision algorithm. There are certain steps in this midpoint subdivision algorithm. Similar to previous algorithm, that is Sudarshan-Cohen line shaping algorithm. First step is read the endpoints of line. Second step is read the corners of clipping window so that we can define the boundaries of clipping window. Third step is assign the region codes depending on the relative position of endpoints of line. We know that there are 9 different subregions and each subregion has its respective region code. A region code is nothing but group of 4 digits. And this group contains combination of zeros and ones. Next step in this algorithm is apply the visibility test on this line. Depending on the visibility of particular line, we have to move further. The output of previous algorithm is if the line is completely visible, display that line. If the line is completely invisible, discard or ignore that line. And third case is if the line is partially visible, we have to follow certain process. In the previous algorithm, we have find out that the intersection points of the line and clipping window. But some different scenario is present in this algorithm. That is, in this midpoint subdivision algorithm, as the name suggests, that we have to find out the midpoint of this line. This line is comes in a third case, that is partially visible line. So here the main motto of this algorithm is to find out the portion which is visible and display that portion and ignore the portion which is out of the boundary. Now, how to find out midpoint? By just having division algorithm, or we can say that divide and conquer strategy is useful for getting the output of this algorithm. Means here, by the process, we need to find out the midpoint of this particular line. Means we are making the division of this line into two equal parts and apply the same process on each segment. Whether particular segment is completely visible or completely invisible or partially visible. Say this midpoint is R. This PR is one segment and RQ is another segment. Apply the same process on each half. That is, find out the region codes of these two endpoints, make the logical AND operation. If it results in non-zero result, then reject the line. If it results in all zeros, then conclude that this particular line segment is again partially visible. If this is a partially visible, then find out the midpoint of this line. Say yes. After this process, this particular PR line segment is divided into two equal parts, that is PS and SR line segments. Now, here we are going to consider first segment, that is PS. On this PS line segment, we have to apply the same process, that is find out the region codes of these two endpoints, perform the logical AND operation of these two endpoints and find out the result. If the result is non-zero, we have to discard this line. The result is obviously non-zero, so we have to discard. find out the region codes. Obviously, the region codes of these S and R are 0, 0, 0. As earlier we have discussed that if the region codes of both the endpoints of line are 0, 0, 0, 0, then that line is completely visible. So, this SR segment is completely visible. So, next step is display this SR. And go further for this remaining segment, that is RQ. Same process will be repeated. Find out the region codes of R and S. Perform the logical AND operation of the same. Find out the result. If the result is not zero, then particular line segment is invisible. But it results in 0, 0, 0, 0. That is, this R is having region codes as 0, 0, 0, 0. And this Q is having region code as 1, 0, 0, 0. So the logical AND operation. Logical AND of this results in all zeros. If it results in all zeros, then it is a partially visible line. Then apply the same process. Find out the midpoint of this RQ. Say T. By this midpoint T, the RQ line segment is divided into RT and TQ. Same process will be repeated. That is, consider this segment RT. Find out the region codes. Perform logical AND operation. And see the result. The same result will be there for this particular line segment. That is, R is having region code 0, 0, 0, 0. T is having region code 1, 0, 0, 0. Logical AND operation of this is all zeros. Means that RT line segment is again partially visible. So, apply the same process. Find out the midpoint. Give the name as Z. Say Z. By this Z, this RT line segment is divided into two equal parts. That is, RZ and ZT. The same process we need to apply on this each segment or each arc. That is, RZ. Find out the midpoint, find out the region codes of this R and Z. Region codes of R and Z are all zeros. If both the points are having region codes as all zeros, then obviously that particular line is completely visible. If the line is completely visible, display that line segment. Now, the same process is repeated for ZT. Now, Z and T, these two endpoints are having region codes. Then perform the logical AND operation. It results in non-zero result. If the result is non-zero, then we have to discard the line segment. The same process happens for this one. That is TQ. On this TQ, the same process is applied. Find out the region codes. Then perform the logical AND operation. Say here, the region codes of T and Q are same. Means 1, 0, 0, 0. The logical AND operation of this is non-zero. That is 1, 0, 0, 0. It results that the line is completely invisible. The line is completely invisible. So we have to just discard this particular line. And our output of this algorithm is whatever the part of this partially visible line that is displayed and the remaining part is just ignored. Based on these two algorithms, we are taking certain examples that as we know that how to assign the region codes or we are taking examples as say the line PQ is present on the screen. We have to apply the visibility test on this line PQ. First of all, we need to find out the region codes of this P and Q. Say the region code of P is 0001. P is having region code as 0001. And Q is having region code as 0000. There is a logical AND operation. Gives us all zero result. That is 1 into 0, 0, 0 into 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, and the same. When the zero result is there, then the line is said to be partially visible. This line is PQ line is partially visible. We will take one example, one more example, that is line AB. Here we have got the region codes of the points present on 9 different subregions. So here A is having region code as 0001. And B is having region code as 0101. The logical AND operation gives us result as 1 into 1, 1, 0 into 0, 0, 0 into 1, 0, 0 into 0, 0. This is a non-zero result. Non-zero result. Now here one clue is there for finding out particular line is completely invisible. One clue is there that you just see the region codes of particular endpoints and the same bit position in the region codes if it is one. That is, at the same bit position, one bit is present, then without using this logical AND operation, we can conclude that particular line is completely invisible. This particular clue will be helpful for finding the line is completely invisible. At the time of university examination, examiner will provide you the region codes of particular endpoints. At that time, by just visualizing the bit positions, we can get the clear idea about the result. That is, either particular line is completely visible or completely invisible or partially visible. We'll take one more example. That is, say the line ST. Here, by just visualizing, we can get the line ST is partially visible. But by following the process of these two algorithms, how we can conclude that this particular line ST is partially visible? By just finding out the region codes of S and T. First of all, write down the region code of this S. As a S is having region code 0, 0, 0, 0. And T is having region code 0, 1, 0, 0. By the earlier clue, by just visualizing this particular bit position, we can get clear idea that at the same bit position, one is not present. And both the region codes are not having all zero region codes. Then particular line is, we can conclude that particular line is partially visible. This particular clue will be helpful for you. So at the end of this particular discussion about these algorithms, we can summarize that if both the region codes of endpoints are all zeros, then that line is completely visible. If both the region codes at the same bit position, one is present, then that line is completely invisible. And if one of the endpoints of the line is having region code all zeros and another endpoint is having the region code like this, then we can perform the logical AND operation, or we can just visualize whether particular bit position has 1. If it is there, then completely invisible. If it is not there, then we can conclude that this particular line ST is a partially visible. Now, one example based on midpoint subdivision algorithm we have to consider. For that, first of all, we need to find out the region codes. Consider the line segment. PQ. First of all, we need to find out the region codes of these P and Q. Already we have the region codes. Region code of P. 0001. Region code of Q is 0000. What are the result? The logical AND operation is all zeros. Now, we are going to find out the midpoint of this line. Same. On this arc, or by the introduction of this arc, this line segment PQ is divided into two different segments. That is PR and second is RQ. Again, the same process we need to apply on these endpoints. Find out the original force, perform the logical operation. If particular endpoint or particular result is non-zero, then completely invisible. And particular result is all zero, then part is visible. So the outcome of this midpoint subdivision algorithm is, by the use of divide and conquer strategy, we will just reduce the work of analyzing the pixels which are outside of the region and inside of the region. Further part we will discuss in the next lecture.